now I've got the wings all cut out and the hubs. And I'm gluing the wings into the hubs. So I put a little bit in the hub and a little bit on the wing. I want to get a good saturation on that glue. I glue these first without the pin. Put the wing pin in after this glue is dry. I haven't even drilled the hole for that yet. Also on these, you'll notice I put the wing tips opposite. So this side goes up. When this side is up, this side is down. I think that looks the best. So they're not the same way. Okay, so that's one hummingbird wing glued. Here's another one that's drying. I'll do a little more sanding on these after this is dry. These are pine, and I had some poplar. I don't know if the poplar is heavier or not, but it's really nice, clear, grain wood, easy to work with. So I'm making this will be my first set of wings I've ever made out of poplar. I'm just cleaning this up with a damp paper towel. All right, here's where we are so far. We just have a few items to kick out here. Got to drill and pin this. I'm going to use 3/16 dowel. Give it extra strength. Got to drill it. I've got a 3/16 drill set up in the drill press. Also going to pin the wings with a 1/16-inch dowel. Halfway. I don't go all the way through. Just halfway so you only see the hole on one side. Got my 1, 2, 3 blocks. Keep it square. See how deep I'm going. Real good. Okay, the next thing is to go ahead and drill these. I've got a little block that I use to support them while I'm drilling them. I'm going to raise the table up a little bit. I'm going to see the depth on this because I only want to go through the blade and no further. I want to come out the other side. I'm going to set the depth stop right there. Do these on opposite sides. Okay, got the holes drilled. So now I just need to put the little glue in there. Let that dry. Next thing is to run some little bushings in here. These are made for the wider hub, so I might make some new bushings. But this is the way they'll work. They'll just fit right in there. That's a 2-inch screw. It's measured from under the cap. And you know, those don't measure exactly 2 inches like they say in the hardware store. Washers, but they just fit that screw just right, and they're brass, So they're 12.8 cents a piece, 13 cents a piece with taxes, just for the washer. And those screws are 58 cents a piece, I think, something like that. At Ace, those screws are $1.50 or $1.58. So I drilled a pilot hole in here. So I'm gonna go ahead and screw this in. All right, I think it's time to start painting.